Dear sisters and brothers, a pleasant good evening to us all. Permit me to welcome you all to today's priestly ordination of our dear brother, Reverend John Paul Atsu Sade, who shall be ordained as a Catholic priest in the Catholic Diocese of St. John's Basseterre. I wish to welcome you all in a very special way, especially for Honorable Charles Fernandez, a representative of the government of Antigua and Barbuda. Shall we give him a round of applause? Also in our midst are the priests and deacons of the province of Castries, who have been here on Monday having their conference and will join us this day as we have this solemn celebration. The Lord said through the prophet Jeremiah that I will give you shepherds after my own heart who will feed you with knowledge and understanding. Today, my dear brothers and sisters, these words of the Lord will be fulfilled in our presence. Ordination to the priesthood takes place within the context of Holy Mass, the rite, most of which dates back many, many centuries, is punctuated with a number of distinct parts. Indeed, it is a time of great joy and celebration on the path of the newly ordained priest, his family and friends, and on those who have supported and encouraged him along the journey of his vocation. The celebration continues with a reception following the Mass of Ordination. And shortly afterwards, the newly ordained priest will celebrate his first Mass, giving thanks to God and to all those who have helped him along the way. His family and friends usually gather for this special Mass, which will be held here on Sunday. Ordained as deacon several months before, Reverend Jean-Paul Atsu Sade prepares himself for the Mass of priestly ordination, dressed in an alb and a diagonally worn stole of deacons. Many of his priest friends join in the ordination of their brother as they welcome him to the one common priesthood of Christ. Reverend Jean-Paul Atsu Sade was born in Togo, West Africa. He grew up in Ivory Coast in Abidjan. He studied French literature in the University of Lomé and later studied philosophy in Accra, Ghana. He joined the Carmelite Order in Burkina Faso, Togo, and the Ivory Coast. Afterwards, he continued his master's in contemporary philosophy and did his theological studies in the Faculty of Theology of the Jesuits in Africa, also in Ivory Coast. Since the year 2018, he has been in touch with this diocese, and in 2020, he arrived in Antigua, where he prepared himself for this great event. My dear brothers and sisters, as we gather to participate in the ordination ceremony, let us prepare ourselves for this solemn celebration. Let us offer prayers to God for Reverend Jean-Paul, who today will respond to the call of God. I humbly ask you to all stand as the choir leads us in singing, "Priestly people, kingly people, holy people, God's chosen people."
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you. My dear brothers and sisters, welcome to this our celebration of God's love as we gather as a priestly people to have one of our brothers, one of our sons, ordained to the ministerial priesthood among us here this afternoon. Before I begin, I would like to welcome all of the clergy who have made their way here this afternoon. I would like to welcome the representative of our government. I would like to welcome those who have come from far and wide, friends and family of Reverend Atsu Jean-Paul Sade. I would like to welcome each and every one of you who have come out this afternoon to pray, to support, and to encourage our brother Atsu as he gives his life to the priesthood. Gathered in the name of Jesus, our Savior and Lord, let us now confidently pray before him, seeking his mercy for all of us, our sinners, in need of his grace and mercy. So let us prepare ourselves now to celebrate these sacred mysteries as we pray. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us all to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
Let us pray. Lord our God, who in governing your people make use of the ministry of priests, grant a persevering obedience to your will to this priest of your, deacon of your church, whom you graciously choose today for the office of the priesthood, so that by his ministry and life he may gain glory for you in Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
The first reading taken from Apocalypse chapter 3, verses 14 and 20 to 22 will be proclaimed by Sister Maria Eunide Voltaire in French, by Mrs. Maria Teresa Farrell in Spanish, and by Mr. Joseph Barry in English.
Lecture du livre de l'Apocalypse. À l'ange de l'Église qui est à la Odyssée, écrit. Ainsi Paul, celui qui est l'Amen, le témoin fidèle et vrai. Le principe est tiède, ni brûlant, ni froid. Je vais te vomir de ma bouche. Tu dis, je suis riche, je me suis enrichi, je ne manque de rien. Et tu ne sais pas ce que tu es malheureux, pitoyable, pauvre, aveugle et nu. Alors je te le conseille. Achète chez moi pour t'enrichir de l'or purifié au feu, des vêtements blancs pour te couvrir et ne pas laisser paraître la honte de ta nudité. Un remède pour l'appliquer sur tes yeux afin que tu vois. Moi, tout ce que faute et je les corrige. Eh bien, sois fervent et convertis-toi. Voici que je me tiens à ta porte et je frappe. Si quelqu'un entend ma voix et ouvre la porte, j'entrerai chez lui. Je prendrai mon repas avec lui et lui avec moi. Le vainqueur, je lui donnerai de siéger avec moi sur mon trône, comme moi-même, après ma victoire, j'ai siégé avec mon Père sur son trône. Celui qui a des oreilles, qu'il entende ce que l'Esprit dit aux Églises. Parole du Seigneur.
Lectura del libro del Apocalipsis. Esto dice el que es el Amén, el testigo fiel y veraz, el origen de todo lo creado por Dios. Mira que estoy aquí, tocando a la puerta. Si alguno escucha mi voz y me abre, entraré en su casa y cenaremos juntos. Al que venza, lo sentaré conmigo en mi trono, junto a mí, lo mismo que yo, cuando vencí, me senté con mi Padre en su trono. El que tenga oídos, que oiga lo que el Espíritu dice a las comunidades cristianas.
A reading from the book of Revelations. The Amen, the faithful and true witness, the source of all of God's creation, says this: Behold, behold, I stand at the door and I knock. And if anyone hears my voice and opens that door, then I will enter his house, and I shall dine with him, and he with me. For I will give the victorious one the right to sit with me on my throne, just as I myself first won the victory and now sit with my Father on his throne. And whoever has ears ought to listen, to hear what the Spirit says to all of the churches. The word of the Lord.
Please join the choir in singing the response to the psalm, "Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord."
Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. I rejoiced because they said to me, "We will go up to the house of the Lord, in it of it gets Jerusalem." Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Jerusalem built as a city, with a compact unity. To it the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. According to the decree for Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord, in a judgment seat for David's house. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
The second reading, taken from Hebrews chapter 7, verses 23 to 28, will be proclaimed by Miss Barbara Bird.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, the Levitical priests were many because they were prevented by death from remaining in office. But Jesus, because he remains forever, has a priesthood that does not pass away. Therefore, he's always able to save those who approach God through him, since he lives forever to make intercession for them. It was fitting that we should have such a high priest, holy, innocent, undefiled, separated from sinners, higher than the heavens. He has no need, as did the high priest, to offer sacrifice day after day, first for his own sins and then for those of the people. He did that once for all when he offered himself. For the law appoints men subject to weakness to be high priests, but the word of the oath, which was taken after the law, appoints a son who has been made perfect forever. The word of the Lord.
Please stand to acclaim the gospel.
According to John. Jesus said to his disciples, Jesus said to his disciples, I am the vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that bears no fruit, he cuts away. And every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes, to make it bear even more. You are pruned already by means of the word that I have spoken to you. Make your home in me as I make mine in you. As a branch cannot bear fruit all by itself, but must remain part of the vine, neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine. You are the branches. Whoever remains in me, with me in him, bears fruit in plenty. For cut off from me, you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me is like a branch that has already been thrown away. He withers. These branches are collected and thrown on the fire, and they are burnt. If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, you may ask what you will, and you shall get it. It is to the glory of my Father that you should bear much fruit, and then you will be my disciples. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, here begins the rite of ordination proper. The bishop will take his seat in front of the altar. The candidate will be called by name, and he will respond accordingly. God's call is a personal call, and each one must respond for himself. The bishop will then inquire from a priest involved in his formation if he has been found worthy to be ordained into the sacred priesthood. With the consent of the whole assembly, he will elect the candidate for ordination. And I invite Deacon Pershing for the calling of the candidate. Afterwards, very Reverend Father George Athanasius Williams will present the candidate to the bishop, after which the bishop will address all of us, particularly the candidate, on the duties of a priest in his homily.
Let him who is to be ordained a priest come forward. Reverend Atsu John Paul Sade.
Present.
Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain Atsu John Paul Sade, our brother, to the responsibility of the priesthood.
Do you know him to be worthy?
After inquiry among the Christian people, and upon the recommendation of those responsible, I testify that he has been found worthy.
Relying on the help of the Lord God, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we choose Atsu John Paul Sade, our brother, for the order of the priesthood. All present say, thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
My dear friends, brothers and sisters, because this, our son, who is for some of you relative and friend, and for some of us a brother and sister in the body of Christ, You have asked that we advance to the order of priesthood. Our brother Atsu Jean-Paul Sade. The church has a few words to speak to us. It is true that God has made his entire holy people a royal priesthood in Christ. Nevertheless, our great high priest himself, Jesus Christ, chose certain disciples to carry out publicly in his name and on behalf of humankind a priestly office in the church. For Christ was sent by the Father, and he in turn sent the apostles into the world, so that through them and their successors, the bishops, he might continue to exercise his priestly office of teacher, priest, and shepherd. Indeed, priests are established co-workers of the order of bishops, with whom they are joined in the priestly office and with whom they are called to the service of the people of God. In being configured to Christ, the eternal high priest, and joined to the priesthood of the bishops, Jean-Paul will be consecrated as true priests of the New Testament, to preach the gospel, to shepherd God's people, and to celebrate the sacred liturgy, especially the Lord's sacrifice. The church now addresses the deacon directly. Now, dear son, I choke a little bit when I have to say dear son, because it makes me feel rather old if you are my son, but I'm required to say dear son. So now, my dear son, you are to be raised to the order of the priesthood. For you, for your part, you will exercise the sacred duty of teaching in the name of Christ, the teacher. Impart to everyone the word of God, which you have received with joy. Meditating on the law of the Lord, see that you believe what you read, that you teach what you believe, and that you practice what you teach. In this way, let what you teach be nourishment for the people of God. Let the holiness of your life be a delightful fragrance to Christ's faithful, so that by word and example you may build up the house which is God's church. I pray, my dear brothers, other brother priests present, and deacons present here today, listen carefully to these words as well, that they may remind you and me of our ordination day also, and who we truly are as priests in the Lord's church. Likewise, Atsu, you will exercise in Christ the office of sanctifying. For by your ministry, the spiritual sacrifice of the faithful will be made perfect, being united to the sacrifice of Christ, which will be offered through your hands in an unbloody way on the altar, in union with the faithful, in the celebration of the sacraments. Understand, therefore, what you do, and imitate what you celebrate. As a celebrant of the mystery of the Lord's death and resurrection, strive to put to death whatever in your members is sinful and to walk in newness of life. Remember when you gather others into the people of God through baptism, and when you forgive sins in the name of Christ and the church in the sacrament of penance, and when you comfort the sick with the holy oil and celebrate the sacred rites, when you offer prayers of praise and thanks to God throughout the hours of the day, not only for the people of God, but for the whole world, remember then that you are taken from among men and appointed on their behalf for those things that pertain to God. Therefore, carry out the ministry of Christ the priest with constant joy and genuine love, attending not to your own concerns, but to those of Jesus Christ. Finally, dear son, exercising for your part the office of Christ, head and shepherd, while united with the bishop and subject to him, strive to bring the faithful together into one family, so that you may lead them to God the Father through Christ in the Holy Spirit. Keep always before your eyes the example of the Good Shepherd, who came not to be served, but to serve, and who came to seek out and save what was lost. In the light of what has been read and shared to you officially by the church, Atsu, I would like to reflect a little bit on the readings that have been read today and how they speak to this moment in your life. When I reflected on Jesus in the first reading of the book of the Apocalypse, saying that he's knocking on the door of our hearts, I wondered about your own heart. When did God knock on the door of your heart in your life that caused you to open your heart to this call to the priesthood? What was it like when he knocked on the door of your heart? I imagine you must have been listening carefully, because that knock on the door of our heart is not a loud, aggressive, forceful knock. It will always have been a gentle, subtle, quiet knock. One that only your heart can hear. But you answered that knock of Jesus Christ. And Jesus says in that first reading, "The one who opens the door to me, I will come and sit with him and share his meal with him." That, Atsu, is the Eucharist. Jesus is saying to you, if you open the door to your heart to him, he will come and sit with you and be with you in your priesthood as you share his body and blood, as you partake of it yourself and share it with others. The assurance Jesus gives you today that as his priest, he will always be with you. And he will be with you in such a way as to nourish you and to strengthen you and to renew your spirit all through your life and through your priesthood. That's what he promises in that first reading today. And he promises this to you as the eternal high priest, the high priest himself, who the scripture tells us today has the power to forgive sins and to get rid of sin in the world and bring new life. It is he, Jean-Paul, that you will, in fact, share with others. This high priest, who by the power of his Holy Spirit has the power to transform all of creation and make it new in him. But there is something else that is also true. Jesus, in the Gospel of John today, speaks of himself as the vine. "I am the true vine," he says, "and you are the branches." The truth is, the door that you open, the door of your heart that you open to Christ, has not been fully opened yet. It's been opened a little bit, and a little bit more every day in your life as you grow in your capacity for loving Jesus and opening your heart and soul to the Father in the Spirit. The door is open ever more widely. And the reason I use that imagery for you is because it is when your love is brought to perfection that the door is finally open completely. And then Jesus says, "Whatever you ask for in my name, you will receive." Between now and then, the work of the branch on the vine as the scripture passage says, is one where the father has to keep pruning and keep watering and manuring, and the branch that has to be carefully taken care of to remain attached to the vine. As I shared yesterday with my brother priest, the way that God brings your love to perfection, the way that God brings your vocation to perfection, is through the many trials and difficulties and obstacles you will face in your life as his priest. Witnessed to by Jesus himself, modeled by Jesus himself in his own life, and all the saints of the early church, and all the bishops and priests of the history of our faith. The suffering you will face, the trials you will be asked to endure, welcome, as difficult as it may seem to you, welcome with joy in your heart. For they are the moments in your life where your love will be purified, and your faith renewed and strengthened, and your hope grow ever more greater in quantity. Those experiences you will have, remember that you, once you are attached to the vine, you will ultimately bear much fruit. When you are bearing fruit, rejoice. When your life is full of successes and graces and consolations, rejoice, because the day will always come when there will be trials and difficulties and desolation. That's the promise we receive. For if we are to rise with Christ, we must, in our turn, experience death in him. Amen. So, my dear friend, welcome to a life of immense joy and peace in Jesus Christ, but also to a life of real trials and difficulties and persecutions of every kind. Be mindful, the more persecuted you feel, the more difficulties there are, it probably means you're doing the right thing. When you meet obstacles all around you, God is saying to you, come, come further on. You are my disciple. Jesus is saying, come, dine with me. Come, share with me ever more deeply, ever more profoundly, the life that I call you to in me. And then, my dear friend, you will experience, as I said a moment ago, the joys and the peace of the priesthood. Remember, finally, remember that the perfection of your love will also be realized in your service to the people of God. The more you spend yourself in the service of the people of God, the more you give yourself to them without allowing them to kill you, the more you give yourself to them, the more you make yourself a manifest presence of Christ in the world, that too is also a means of purifying your love and bringing it to perfection. Do not be afraid. Remember these words of Jesus: if you open your heart to me, I will come and dine with you, and we will share a meal together. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Having given his homily address to us and to the deacon awaiting to be ordained priest, the bishop now will examine him on his readiness to undertake the office of sacred priesthood. This then will be followed by the solemn promise of obedience. We all gathered here will be invited by the bishop to prayer. Together we shall invoke the whole church in heaven to intercede for us by praying the litany of the saints. The candidate will prostrate himself on the ground during this prayer to signify his nothingness before God. After the litany of saints, the bishop will lay his hands on the candidate. And this is the highest moment of the ordination ritual, followed by the prayer of consecration by the bishop. By these twin actions, the Holy Spirit will confer on the candidate the dignity of the sacred priesthood. We, as an assembly, shall participate in that event by standing in silent prayer.
Dear son, before you enter the order of the priesthood, you must declare before the people your intention to undertake this office. Do you resolve with the help of the Holy Spirit to discharge without fail the office of priesthood in the presbyteral rank as a worthy fellow worker with the order of bishops in caring for the Lord's flock?
I do.
Do you resolve to exercise the ministry of the word worthily and wisely, preaching the gospel and teaching the Catholic faith?
I do.
Do you resolve to celebrate faithfully and reverently, in accord with the Church's tradition, the mysteries of Christ, especially the sacrifice of the Eucharist and the sacrament of reconciliation, for the glory of God and the sanctification of the Christian people?
I do.
Do you resolve to implore with us God's mercy upon the people entrusted to your care by observing the command to pray without ceasing?
I do.
Do you resolve to be united more closely every day to Christ the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a pure sacrifice, and with him to consecrate yourself to God for the salvation of all?
I do, with the help of God.
Do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors?
I do. Put the microphone by your Lord. I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment.
Amen.
My dear people, let us now pray that God, the all-powerful Father, will pour out abundantly the gifts of heaven on this, his servant, whom he has chosen for the office of priests.
We now stand.
Christ of mercy,
Christ of
Virgin of virgins, pray for us.
Saint Michael and all the angels of God, pray for us.
All you saints of God, by your life and death, you proclaim Jesus Christ as the light of the world. All you saints of God, pray for us.
Holy saints of God, pray for us.
Saint John the Baptist,
Saint Joseph,
Saint Peter and Saint Paul,
Saint Andrew,
Saint John,
Saint Mary Magdalene,
all your apostles and saints, companions of the Lord, pray for us.
All you saints of God, by your life from death, you proclaim Jesus Christ as the light of the world. All you saints of God, pray for us.
Saint Stephen,
Saint Ignatius,
Saint Lawrence,
Saint Perpetua and Saint Felicity,
Saint Agnes,
Holy Martyrs of Uganda,
Holy Martyrs and Saints, witnesses for the Lord, pray for us.
Saints of God, by your life and death, you proclaim Jesus Christ as the light of the world. All you saints of God, pray for us.
All you saints of God, pray for us.
Saint Gregory,
Saint Augustine,
Saint Athanasius,
Saint Basil,
Saint Martin,
Saint Benedict,
Saint Bernard,
Saint Francis and Saint Dominic,
Saint Francis Xavier,
Saint John Vianney,
Saint Catherine,
Saint Teresa,
all you founders and saints, upbuilding the church, faithful servants of Christ, pray for us.
All you saints of God, by your life and death, you proclaim Jesus Christ as the light of the world. All you saints of God, pray for us.
Holy saints of God, pray for us.
Saint Vincent de Paul,
Saint Martin de Porres,
Saint Rose of Lima,
Saint Therese of Lisieux,
all men and women saints, pray with Christ, watching with Christ, pray for us.
Pray for us.
All saints of God, by your life and death, you proclaim Jesus Christ as the light of the world. All you saints of God, pray for us.
John Bosco,
Saint John Baptist de la Salle,
Saint Dominic Savio,
Saint Maria Goretti,
all you saints of God, mothers of youth, devoted to you.
Jesus Christ as the light of the world. All you saints of God, pray for us.
All you saints of God, pray for us.
Lord, be merciful. Lord, save your people. From all evil,
Lord, save your people.
From every sin,
Lord, save your people.
From everlasting death,
Lord, save your people.
By your coming as man,
Lord, save your people.
By your death and rising to new life,
Lord, save your people.
By your gift of the Holy Spirit,
Lord, save your people.
Be merciful to us sinners.
Bless your chosen one.
Bless
your chosen one
and make him holy.
Bless your chosen one, make him holy, and set him apart for sacred duties. Jesus, Son of the living God,
Lord,
hear
our prayer.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Hear us, we beseech you, Lord our God, and pour out on this servant of yours the blessing of the Holy Spirit and the power of priestly grace, that this man, whom in the sight of your mercy we offer to be consecrated, may be surrounded by your rich and unfailing gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. We shall invite all priests to the sanctuary as we lay hands on Reverend John Paul.
Draw near, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, Author of human dignity. It is you who apportion all graces. Through you, everything progresses. Through you, all things are made to stand firm. To form a priestly people, you appoint ministers of Christ your Son by the power of the Holy Spirit, arranging them in different orders. Already in the earlier covenant, offices arose established through mystical rites. When you set Moses and Aaron over your people to govern and sanctify them, you chose men next in rank and dignity to accompany them and assist them in their task. So too in the desert, you implanted the spirit of Moses in the hearts of 70 wise men, and with their help, he ruled your people with greater ease. So also upon the sons of Aaron, you poured an abundant share of their father's plenty, that the number of the priests prescribed by the law might be sufficient for the sacrifices of the tabernacle, which were a shadow of the good things to come. But in these last days, Holy Father, you sent your Son into the world, Jesus, who is apostle and high priest of our confession. Through the Holy Spirit, he offered himself to you as a spotless victim, and he made his apostles, consecrated in the truth, sharers in his mission. You provided them also with companions to proclaim and carry out the work of salvation throughout the whole world. And now we beseech you, Lord, in our weakness, to grant us this helper that we need to exercise the priesthood that comes from the apostles. Grant, we pray, Almighty Father, in this your servant, the dignity of the priesthood. Renew deep within him the spirit of holiness. May he henceforth possess this office, which comes from you, O God, and is next in rank to the office of bishop. And by the example of his manner of life, may he instill right conduct. May he be a worthy co-worker with our order, so that by his preaching and through the grace of the Holy Spirit, the words of the gospel may bear fruit in human hearts and reach even to the ends of the earth. Together with us, may he be a faithful steward of your mysteries, so that your people may be renewed in the waters of rebirth and nourished from your altar, so that sinners may be reconciled and the sick raised up. May he be joined with us, Lord, in imploring your mercy for the people entrusted to his care and for all the world. And so may the full number of the nations gathered together in Christ be transformed into your one people and made perfect in your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. So, my dear brothers and sisters, with a prayer of consecration over, Reverend Jean-Paul Atsu Sade is now Reverend Father Jean-Paul Atsu Sade. Reverend Father Jean-Paul Atsu Sade will be given his new liturgical garments, the stole and the chasuble. His palms will be anointed with sacred chrism so that he may bless and consecrate people and objects in the name and person of Jesus Christ. The newly ordained will then come before the bishop to receive the gifts of bread and wine, which he will henceforth offer on behalf of God's people. Finally, the bishop, together with all priests gathered here, will give him the kiss of peace, a gesture indicating that he has been accepted into the order of priests. We shall also offer the newly ordained our congratulations at the appropriate time. May I now invite Very Reverend Father Lawrence Malama to give our newly ordained his new liturgical garments.
Whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer a sacrifice to God. Amen.
Amen.
To bring the chalice to me. It's full of wine. I hope he doesn't spill it. Receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross.
Amen.
Amen. Careful, it's full of wine.
both on the left side and the right side. I'm gonna hug you both ways.
We shall invite all priests to come and congratulate him as the choir gives us a song. Just so that we all are aware, Reverend Father Jean-Paul Atsu Sade is a twin, and his brother is also a priest. So I'd like to also introduce to you Reverend Father John Peter Eche Sade.
Please come forward.
So that is the twin brother of Reverend Father John Paul. So this is John Paul and John Peter. See the resemblance, yeah. With joy in our hearts, we shall offer our gifts to the Lord as the choir leads us in medley of songs. We shall invite the Hispanic community to lead us in the collection.
The congregation is asked to remain seated during the procession of gifts. Thank you.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who have willed that your priests should minister the holy altar and serve your people, grant by the power of this sacrifice, we pray, that the labors of your servants may constantly please you, and in your church bear that fruit which lasts forever, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son, High Priest of the new and eternal covenant, and by your wondrous design were pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred mystery through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim.
Lord God above.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and a living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make us an eternal offering to you, so that we may be obtaining an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostle and glorious martyr, and with all the saints, and whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
Okay. Once you reach this part, the world, go straight over to that. I'll show you. Start this.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Robert Llanos, our Bishop, with the Order of Bishops, this your servant, who has been ordained today as a priest for the church, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who have been pleasing to you at the passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
And before the Epiclesis, we remember also now the father, Father Jean-Paul's father, Paul Sade, and his brother, Daniel Sade, who are deceased. We are mindful of them, and we are praying for him in heaven right now. And so, Father, we ask that you receive them always into your kingdom, that they may share in the glory of your Son, Jesus. For through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. My dear friends, at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say. Lord, we pray from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace and the joy of Jesus Christ be with you always.
Let us now offer each other the sign of peace.
Oh, yes, Jesus.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our first communion hymn, I am the vine, you are the branches. Second communion hymn, How I Have Longed to Draw You to Myself. The choir will now lead us in the meditation, "Here I Am, Lord."
I love you.
Let us pray. May the divine sacrifice we have offered and received, O Lord, give new life to your priests and to all your servants, that united to you in unfailing love, they may receive the grace of giving worthy service to your majesty, through Christ our Lord.
Do we have announcements? Yeah.
Please be seated for the announcements.
You bring this back after.
God is good and all the time. Amen. Good evening, brothers and sisters in Christ. Well, I have a simple mission this evening, but sometimes it can become a very frightening mission. I am to say thank you. But why I'm saying it may be frightening is I am afraid that I will leave one or two out. So, may the cuckoo, did you hear that? I said, I am begging you from the beginning, may the cuckoo, that is in Togolese. So before I attempt to go through a litany of people to say thank you to, as we do on occasions like this, I would like, first of all, to thank God, to acknowledge what God has done, not only for us today, this evening, but for leading Jean-Paul to the shores of Antigua and Barbuda. And of course, to the Diocese of St. John's, Basseterre. If that didn't happen, and the second part that made this day possible, I would like to thank, maybe I will be a little formal today, His Excellency, Most Reverend Robert A. Llanos, Bishop of St. John's, Basseterre. You know, sometimes you recognize something in someone without even laying your eyes on that person. That is what Bishop did. He saw something in Jean-Paul without even seeing him. How possible is that? It is possible because of God, because the Holy Spirit is at work. Amen? Amen. So we thank Bishop for making this day possible and for taking the time to ordain this son of his as a priest for the Diocese of St. John's, Basseterre. He has his family and relatives and friends here. I would like to thank them for making the journey all the way to Antigua and Barbuda. It's just a dot in the sea, but they found it and they are here. So we welcome you and we are happy that you are here with us tonight. I would like to thank Jean-Paul. Oh, sorry. Reverend Father Jean-Paul for accepting and making himself available for this day and to become a priest in this diocese. Of course, even though Bishop has recognized something in him, he had to say, yes, I want to do it. So we thank you, Father Jean-Paul, for saying yes to God for this diocese. There are visitors from around the diocese, BVI, I think St. Kitts also, and we have the priests and the deacons of the province of Castries here, and I would like to thank them through their president, Monsignor Michel Francis. He's the president. Even though we don't look alike, I can claim that we are twins, because we were born on the same day and in the same year. Just different continent. When I was thinking about the Togolese who are in Antigua at this moment, I thought to myself that is a history. We are making a history in Antigua, because I don't think there is any time in the history of Antigua, except maybe many Togolese came here as slaves, but I'm taking it from independence, that there are so many Togolese in Antigua at the same time and under the same roof. So I think as Togolese, we make history today. That is what I can say, Antigua me come from. Because, well, I'm more Antiguan than Togolese now. There are many other people that I would like to say thank you to. I'm not sure how to go about it. Maybe I will just call names and their teams. For something like this to happen, there must be committees, people working in the background. So I would like to thank Mrs. Morvet Thomas, Mrs. Nolene Azil, and their teams for the good work they have done. If you look around, you also realize that the church, the sanctuary, looks brand new. All these decorations, there are so many people behind it. Yes, there's some company to help, but there are many people who clean and did the decoration. So I would like to thank Mrs. Teresa Gregory and her team. There are many. Pat Ho is there, Joyce, Donna, their group, and waving have the people from Bivia Tortola who also help with the decoration and the cleaning. For those who prepare the liturgy, say thank you. In a special way, I want to thank our MC, little George, or George Jr. With Father Manuel, who worked to put the program together. Mrs. Charmaine Donovan, who, because of her, we have this booklet. The choir, Mrs. Maturin. The musicians. Those at the back on the sound screen. And those watching online, I want to thank them. And by doing that, I am acknowledging those who are working hard every time we have Mass, so that those who are far and wide, especially many people in Togo and around the diocese, in Europe and in America who are following, it is because we have these dedicated men and women who are behind and to make sure that they join us and pray with us. So, as I said, I don't want to make enemies, but I'm thanking each and every one of you. No part is small. Even your coming here made this day special. So, thank you for coming, and I'm going to leave the rest and say, put it this way, that even if I don't mention your name tonight, you are acknowledged, and I am leaving you in the hands of our newest priest, that as he offers his first Mass, he is going to bring you before the Lord and pray for each and every one of you who have helped him to reach the altar of the Lord. God is good and all the time. Now, to finish, I'm going to ask those from Togo to come here. We have a little song just to say thank you. The song is just to say thank you. So it's not a meditation, or just part of the thank you, a vote of thanks. So I invite my sisters here to come. Don't be shy now.
Mm-hmm.
The newly ordained has a twin brother. The Vicar General has also discovered his twin brother here. I don't know if Your Grace, you also have a twin brother amongst us. I know my twin brother. So my dear brothers and sisters, it is now time for the blessings. The newly ordained will bless each and every one of us. I want to humbly invite the Bishop, Most Reverend Robert Llanos, to come forward to receive the blessing from the newly ordained. This will be followed by the Vicar General, the Vocations Director, together with the Co-Cathedral Administrator of St. Kitts and Nevis.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I now invite the Vicar General, the Cathedral Administrator, the Co-Cathedral Administrator, and the President of the Province of Castries.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
We shall invite the family of Reverend Father Jean-Paul Atsu Sade for a special blessing.
Le Seigneur soit avec toi. Que Dieu Tout-Puissant te bénisse, le Père, le Fils et le Saint-Esprit. Le Seigneur soit avec vous. Que Dieu Tout-Puissant vous bénisse, le Père, le Fils et le Saint-Esprit.
I shall now invite all of us to stand as we receive blessings from Reverend Father Jean-Paul Atsu Sade.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please be seated. Thank you very much, Reverend Father Jean-Paul Atsu Sade. I would like to also acknowledge the presence of Honorable Charles Fernandez, a representative of the government of Antigua and Barbuda. Shall we give him a round of applause? We thank you very much. You have been with us from the beginning to this point. We are really grateful and God bless you. After the final blessing and the reception, we shall have an order of photography. Just when the priest, together with Bishop, have recessed, we are begging that Bishop will come back to the sanctuary to have a photograph with the newly ordained priest, followed by the Vicar General and the new priest, the administrators, both the cathedral and co-cathedral, all priests gathered here, the twin brother of Father John Paul, that's Father John Peter, the family of the new priest, provincial priests, the new priest, and other photos. Thank you very much for your presence here, and may God continue to bless us all. We shall invite you on Sunday. We are actually inviting you on Sunday to join Reverend Father John Paul to celebrate his Thanksgiving Mass here at the Cathedral at 9 a.m. Let us come in our numbers to give thanks to God for the gift of the priesthood. Once again, thank you for your presence. After Mass, there is something for us all to exercise the jaw. Thank you very much.
Before the final blessing, two brief announcements. A reminder that tomorrow evening at 6 p.m. Mass, we will have a concelebrated Mass with all those priests you see sitting outside there from the various islands of the Castries province. So these are priests from Dominica, St. Lucia, Antigua, the island, the Diocese of St. John's, Basseterre, Grenada, and St. Vincent, okay, that are all here this week for a meeting. So they will celebrate a concelebrated Mass tomorrow evening at 6 p.m. All of you are welcome. Please come and be blessed. That's one announcement. The second announcement is, I don't think you all realize the power of the blessing of a priest right after his ordination. I want you to understand, make it a point to get to Father Jean-Paul Sade and ask him to give you a blessing. That blessing, I can assure you, I speak with utter confidence, is a very powerful blessing. Don't miss it. But at the same time, don't kill him out. So, between now and Sunday, when he celebrates officially his first Mass, which will not probably be his first Mass, but you know what I mean, on Sunday at 9 a.m., you can get the blessing anytime during this time, okay? So, ask him for his blessing wherever you can, okay? It's a very important thing. What has happened in the diocese is today is a very important event. I hope people understand in the diocese the importance of receiving a new priest in the ministry of the Diocese of St. John's Basseterre. It's an extremely important blessing. For those who know better, when you're ordaining a new priest, the devil makes life very difficult for those around him who are helping him prepare for his priesthood, including the bishop and the people organizing all these events. You may not understand, but trust me when I tell you, it is a big deal when a priest is ordained and you have a new priest in your diocese. Don't take this lightly, okay? Amen? Did I forget anything? I think those are the two things I had to announce. Okay, that's it. Please stand for the final blessing. May God, who founded the church and guides her still, protect you constantly with his grace, that you may faithfully discharge the duties of the priesthood. Amen. May he make you a servant and witness in the world to divine charity and truth, and a faithful minister of reconciliation. And may he make you a true shepherd to provide the living bread and word of life to the faithful, that they may continue to grow in the unity of the body of Christ. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Mass is ended. Let us go forth and serve the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
A recessional hymn, To God Be the Glory.
General.